Okay, no, I know I've been, I don't know what that last video was. I could not grasp the mathematical of the generations from my great grandmother. I'm sorry. Yeah, but in correction, she is only like a half breed, and it would be her father or her grand, or her father or her mother were 100% Indian. So in when you're looking at this, that gets a little creepy. Like, was the mother like one of those, like an abandoned woman who was pregnant and Indian? Was it one of those types of situations by a white man? Thusly, there is my Guadalupe great-grandmother. You know, is it one of those situations? So it starts registering in your mind, you know, the evils, you know, that men can do. In that time frame, it was pretty awful, you know, when Indian was spoken, when they were Comanches, you know. The Comanches had, they had Texas, they had New Mexico, they had down to Chihuahua, they had up to Colorado. They had a huge, huge area, and yes, they did intermingle with the Apaches. So that was a, there was a rough haul group. But anyway, what I really wanted, and that, they were put on reservation in 1875. They were pre-reservation before that, but they were beaten down essentially to be corralled in 1875. My grandmother was born in 1880, so whether the white man was going and visiting these reservations as a guest to make sure they were all behaving, I don't know. I don't know what happened to the women at that time, but your mind does wander and go, oh, they were, I bet you they were just jerks. I bet you they were just jerks. So, and then of course she could have just been one of those, like an adopted type. You could go back to the pure and wonderful, you know, maybe she was just adopted because, well, they abandoned. They had no parents. Maybe the parents were killed, you know, somehow. Or the mother died in childbirth and the father wasn't present. We didn't know where the father was. Yeah, so it could have been one of those. So she was adopted by some good people who raised her. So it was all kinds of things we are still mystery with. But yeah, those types of stories is how did your Indian get into your line, you know, how did it? You know, just makes you wonder. Yeah. So, back to reality here. I still have to keep up the good work of saving the planet. And tonight, I should have done this a long time ago. I know I just threw a long time ago when I was in France. I'm just like, just put olive oil in your hair, everybody. I can't stand it anymore. But I'm for conditioner, a good tonic. Instead of using conditioner, is use the two tablespoons of apple cider vinegar, 1 cup of water, and 10 drops of a aromatic fragrance. It can be lavender oil, it can be a geranium oil, it can be a tea tree oil, depending your particular way you are. I had that one, the Geronimo one. I had that one, and it is like, whoa, really strong. And I also had the tea tree, and that one's really strong. So they're more antiseptic-y, but they get rid of the apple cider smell. But it does work, because I have some really, 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 really tight curls in the back of my head here. And it really works to relax them because they're annoying. They're just always, you know. So if you have to put some conditioner on, it's an easy one and it doesn't require all those bottles from the store. And it kind of frees you from their machine I have to have my conditioner, you know, it frees you from it. And yeah, try it for a while. And apparently people are having good luck with it out there. You can seek it out yourself. In the updates of my cookies, I'm making some cookies, but they're actually like crack. Not that I know what crack is, but oh my gosh, I would eat maybe one of these or two of these at night, and I'm like awake, and it's 3 o'clock in the morning. So whatever's in this cookie, I can't eat at night. They have it's just chocolate. They're chocolate cookies. Okay, now it's a basic recipe. I'll try to list it out there. It's a chocolate cocoa. Just cocoa powder, organic cocoa powder. Yes, you can buy it. It's expensive, but you don't use very much. So you buy the organic cocoa powder, and some stores are more pricey than others. Okay. Then you mix that with the flax, the ground flax. A couple tablespoons of those. You throw in some olive oil. As your mixer, then you can also add to this, these cookies, you can add the milk, the almond milk, an unsweetened almond milk, go for that if you want. Go ahead and put the honey in also, because it has to have a sweet extra, because we're sweet fanatics, even though we may be vegans. I don't know what to do about the bees. But in a way, maybe if we are bee hungry, not bee hungry, but honey hungry, maybe that would force industries to continue bees rather than destroy them. So then that, and then add like some whole wheat flour in there, some baking powder, some vanilla, and mix that all up. And then throw in some chocolate chips and try to find organic. That's a toughie, I know. Try to find the darker so it doesn't have the milk fat in it. And then you're like, mix that all up. And it's more like a biscotti dough. It can be that heavy. And it's kind of fun. And so you take it, you roll it into little balls. Then you put it in all the pans and then you smash them like peanut butter cookies, just with your fingers if you want. You smash them, smash, 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 smash. And then after a while you have maybe 2 or 3 dozen of these. You put them all in the oven at one time and you cook them for about, I put them on there for about 18 minutes and then I turn the oven off and at 350. And then that's it. And then you take them out. And they're a little heavy, but depending on how many chocolate chips you put in there, they are just like, whoa, like power monsters. If you need to like stay awake for some reason, you just need to, you know, do an all-night study or something. Something in the chocolate powder. And these can be also thought of as Aztec style, but they didn't have the matzah. I didn't go with matzah with this one. This is just a regular for normal people. You can use gluten-free, of course, also. But they're very delicious. And yeah, and they just keep you awake. So, whoa. Anyway, out there on Ancestry.com, I released my line. It's what I have there on the family search. I just put it on the Ancestry. And it doesn't have pictures, it doesn't have the photos that the family search does, but it doesn't matter. It has all the names. I put up 24 generations. So it heads back to like the time when the kings really start kicking in full on. And so I met some, I don't know, it's 20,000 plus names, maybe 28,000. I don't know. I think this one is only about 20,000, but it's the convergence of my grandmother and my grandfather and from my dead mother. Yeah, she died a terrible death, my mother. It was a long drawn out affair of a female cancer. She took those estrogens in the 60s. There weren't estrogen good, they were those estrogen baths. She took those heavy doses in the 60s. She took them in later on. They used them for the pill. She took really, really heavy doses. They were like 10 times or 20 times the amount that they give today. And it's surmising to believe that it gave her the cancer, her female cancers. So, thusly, just about half a year before she died, they gave her hysterectomy, the whole thing, and so it was awful for her. She couldn't handle it. But she did die in France. She went to France with me. She took her dog there, Mr. Rudy Ruski from El Paso. She took him there, and he is a Siberian, but I believe his Siberian mix might have some Samoyed in there, might also have some kind Malamute. But what a gorgeous dog that ran away a lot. So unfortunately, I did not raise puppies from him, because the closest one near was in Romania, and I lived in France, and he was running away too much, so I had him castrated. Castrier, they call it. So everybody hated me because I didn't give puppies out from this beautiful dog. So that's another, like, what do you call that? A thunk on my head. Like, how could she even live? She didn't make puppies out of that gorgeous dog. Well, the gorgeous dog ran away a lot. He was a terrible. He's still a wild wolf. That particular breed, he's on my website there on the blog. That particular breed was brought over, the Chukchis, were brought over from Russia, 1900s, very brand new, those reds. Any of those red huskies are very new, so they're very much not tamed, and even though he went to school, my mother even took him to a special school back east, in like Illinois somewhere, Indianapolis, no, Illinois, I don't know, but it cost a lot of money, and she did this like just before, like the last year in her death year. She went to dog training school with this notorious husky puller, and it was a good one, you know, it was a school, they take them down and they make him spin, you know, he had to, you know, she had to do certain things with this dog. But he is a trickster, he is a circus dog. There's nothing we can do about him, but she did train him really well. We got him walking on planks because he was so badly behaved. But given the chance away from his trainer, and he runs away. So, yeah, he just says, smell of, you know, the smell of the scent of, oh, the smell of the scent of France. He went insane. He went insane with happiness. So many wonderful smells in France along the country ways, you know. So he was he was a provoker to my other dog. So what was I saying? Yeah, that's all. I think that's it. That's where I was at. Was that it? I released my 30,000 names. And it looks good. It looks good on Ancestry. It looks so pretty when you see the tree like that. Like that. It's like, whoa. That's incredible. I can only say thank you to all of the people that have spent years and years and years and years of their lives putting together this one and that one and the other. My grandmother and my grandfather, they spent many years in genealogy. My grandfather used to take trips down to the library in Texas and look at microfiche films of who died in the obituaries. He would do so much research for other people also. I mean, he was a maverick and very helpful. And so for him, if he was alive today, he would be just thrilled at how much is available. And there's the sources, so easy. But yeah, it's still a tough haul. I may have, you know, lines that head out there to the kings real quick, and you go, whoa, 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 you know, catch that one. And it's wonderful, but there's a lot of blanks. There's a lot of blanks. Like you head down the Williams line, and it's blank after a while. So I've got a lot of blanks. So anyway, that's all. It's just kind of, this is a vlog update of, I don't know, just a talk, because a talk has to happen. Oh, I bought a, today, it was a replacement. You cannot believe it. I had this beautiful little rosemary bush, a little tiny one, and it would not grow. It would not do anything except dry out and die. And then I'm like, oh, because all of my other plants are doing okay. It's a very windy location, but they're doing okay. And I'm like, what am I going to do with this one? It's just dying. So I had to take it back to the store and get a replacement. So my replacement was a crepe myrtle. And it's small, but it hopefully will tree form. And the crepe myrtle, I love it. I don't have space for it, though. I have no space for it. It's a 25 by 25 at the end of the day, and its life is a tree. But I'm going to try to épalier it, and so I can't fill the hole where the little rosemary went. Now I have to go dig another hole in the rocks. And it's tough here. It's really tough. And no, my watermelons have not grown yet. It has not been the garden flourishing yet. It's still young soil. It's just growing certain things. I will have corn. I will have, you know, I do have potatoes. I do have certain things growing. But yeah, certain things are taking their time, way too much. Because this particular area, I know I'm allowed to have watermelons twice a year and cantaloupes twice a year. And I'm not getting that production yet. So I believe it has to do with the soil itself, just was not satisfied. I think it has to be very rich soil. And maybe there were some types of pesticides in from the garden that was there before, which was just grass, you know, just the grassy knoll. Anyhoot, so that's it. That's all. That's all I have tonight. 17 minutes of yab of Teresa.